Hi everyone and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, we're going to be having a look at how we can create a similar animated scroll down icon with the help of Elementor Page Builder, the Pro version. You're going to need the Pro version because we're going to need a little bit of custom CSS code. And also we're going to make this icon clickable, so it is going to send the user to a specific point on your page once the user clicks on this icon. So, as I've said, this tutorial is for Elementor Pro, but this same effect, this same animated scroll down icon is absolutely possible to create with the help of the free Elementor version, and we have also got a video about that on our channel, so go check this video out, and you're going to be able to create this animated scroll down icon with the help of Elementor free. And you do not need a lot of knowledge of code, because it is all very intuitive and beginner-friendly, and I'm going to explain every single step to you, so it's not going to be complicated. So there is a lot of types of creative scroll-down indicators online on a lot of award-winning websites. They improve the user experience and help your visitors navigate across your website. And if you're looking for a beautiful and functional, professionally made website design for your web project, check out TemplateMonster.com, where you can find thousands of WordPress themes to any taste and suitable for any business niche. Or if you need WordPress themes or plugins in bulk, check out One by TemplateMonster, which is a subscription service. If you subscribe, you get access to over 10,000 of products that include WordPress themes and CMS templates, e-commerce themes, plugins, including Jet plugins for WordPress and graphics, presentation templates, illustrations, and a lot more. If you're interested, check out the links in the description. So now let's start with creating this animated scroll down icon. First, let's look for the icon widget and add it to our page. Here, since Elementor has introduced the new icon library, you're able to upload your own SVG files, and if you want some specific icon to be the scroll down indicator, you can upload the SVG file or you can use one of the icons present in the default library. I simply type in down and here I have a number of different arrows. I'm going to choose this one because I feel like for tutorial it's a little bigger and it's going to be a little bit more visible. What we're doing now is changing its color, and we can also change the size of this icon, make it bigger or make it smaller. We're pretty much done in here. This is the basic setup that we need to then later go and add some CSS code. You can also change the style of this icon on hover, but for now we're done with the basic setup, and I'm going to go to the advanced tab, scroll down and find the custom CSS tab, which is only going to be there if you have Elementor Pro. So with Elementor Free, you do not have this tab. Now let me simply paste this code snippet in here in this field, and I'm going to insert this same code snippet in the comments, so you can simply copy it and insert it on your own website for your own icon. And I'm going to quickly go over it and explain to you every single line. I made the interface a little bit bigger, so I hope you can see it better. So now for the element to which you want to apply this custom CSS, you name it selector, and then I have inserted these four lines. These are four different properties, but the values are the same. It is needed because we want to ensure that this animation works for all of the browsers. And you have to make sure that the values that you put in here have to be the same for each of these four properties. So in all of these four lines, the values have to be the same. Now let's go and see what the values actually mean. So here, the first word here is the name of your animation. And as you see, since I have changed the name in the first line, I have to go over and change the name in the rest of the three lines. And also change it here next to the keyframes, and I'm going to explain to you what the keyframes section actually is a little later. So, as you see, the name has to be the same here. The next, it is the duration of the animation. So, in our case, the animation takes 3 seconds. It takes 3 seconds for it to start, go to the midpoint, to the 50% of the animation, and go to the 100%. which means to end. And this entire thing takes 3 seconds. If we change it to 7, it's going to go a little slower. And if we change it to 1 second, it's going to go faster. Then ease is the type of the interpolation. It means that at the beginning of the animation, it's going to go a little slower, then it's going to speed up closer to the middle of the animation, and then it's going to go slower again at the end of the animation. So it helps to make it a little smoother. And then infinite means that this animation is going to loop, it's going to be infinite, and it's going to continuously repeat over time. Then if you change this value to, let's say, 2, the animation is going to only repeat 2 times. So if you want the animation to repeat a specific number of times, just set this number in here instead of the word infinite. But I'm going to go with the infinite value for this tutorial because I want it to move all the time. And now let's proceed to the keyframes section. And this section basically helps us to imagine the timeline, the entire timeline of the animation. So 0 is the point where our animation starts, then 50% is where it reaches the middle of the timeline. In our case, it's 40 pixels down. So our arrow starts its movement at the top here, then it moves 40 pixels down, and then it gets back to its initial position, which happens at 100%. So it starts, then it moves 40 pixels down, and it gets back up to 0. Now, if you want this icon to move, let's say, more pixels down, if you want the amplitude of the movement to be a lot bigger, you can change this value, or you can make the value bigger, or you can make the value smaller. Simply adjust this value, the number of pixels, just adjust them to your taste. All right, now what we could do is actually put this icon somewhere so the user sees it once they enter our website. And I'm going to change the width to inline so the widget doesn't take up the width of the entire page. And then I'm changing the position to absolute, which means I'm now allowed to grab this widget and drag it around and place it anywhere I like. And I want to place it in here. You can just drag it and drop it where you want, or you could also use the sliders. And I'm going to use the percentage because I feel it's going to be a little bit more accurate. So something like that, or we could actually move it a little bit to the right. There we are. So this is what the user is going to see once they enter your website. And the one thing that is left for us to do is to make this icon clickable. So the user can not only scroll down the page, they can also click on this icon and they're going to be sent to this specific section on your website. What I want to do is I want to actually go to this section here where the menu starts, and I want to select this section. Go to the settings of this section, click edit section here. And then if we go to advanced, we can give this particular section a specific ID. CSS ID, you see it in the CSS ID field. Now, once we have set it, we have to copy it. And then go to this icon again, find the link field in the content tab, insert the number sign, and then insert the CSS ID that we have given to this section. And as you see, once I click on this icon, it now sends me to this specific section. So this section is now at the top of my viewport. Now let's quickly go over the process of adjusting the position of this icon for the mobile devices. Since the position is absolute, it is going to jump to a different place if we switch to the mobile layout or to the tablet layout. Let's go to the tablet layout for now. And as you see here, now we have to adjust the position for the tablet layout as well. So now it's on its place when you switch to the tablet device. But if you want to hide this icon entirely, you can go to the responsive tab and you can choose hide on tablet and hide on mobile for this specific widget. So this was pretty much it for this tutorial on how to create this animated scroll down icon with Elementor Pro. If you liked this tutorial, leave us your thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more Elementor tutorials. Thank you so much for watching.